Hey guys, what's up? I just wanted to do a short video here to kind of give you guys my thoughts or impressions on this knife. Initially, I wasn't going to do a video review on this because honestly, it is so similar to the standard Benchmade 940. But I decided, you know, some of you guys might be in the market for a 940. You're having a hard time deciding between the standard aluminum handle version or this new G10 version of the 940-2. So I said, what the heck, I'll do a quick little 5-minute video showing the 940-2. So overall, guys, this is pretty much the same knife as the Benchmade 940. And that's the reason why I was reluctant to really do a review on this knife or really give it some video time. But there are some differences, mostly aesthetic, a little bit different shaping of the handles, obviously handle material. But in terms of its role and utility, if you had a, you know, 940 with the green handles or the 940-2, they're going to carry and operate pretty much the exact same. So it's kind of why I was not super, super excited, you know, to do a video on this knife. You know, it was popular. It was a you know, big thing for this knife to come out. I think it came out last summer 2016. So this is January 2017 now. So it's been out for about 6 months, and this is actually the first one that I've gotten in for service. So I'm not exactly sure how well they're selling, but I think they are selling pretty good. So just quickly here, let's hit on the differences or changes with this guy versus our standard 940. So obviously we have G10 handles. Original 940 had aluminum handles, and you know, quite frankly, they didn't wear very well. If you dropped it or nicked it or scraped it, it would show, you know, the aluminum would show, you know, through the paint, and it was pretty much that way forever. So in terms of durability, I think the 940-2 is a much better choice in that regard. So, you know, even compared this knife to a paramilitary 2, which many of you guys opposed and said, no, these knives are not comparable. This is a, you know, a gentleman's EDC knife and the paramilitary 2, blah, blah, blah. But honestly, this knife and the paramilitary 2 are pretty much some of the top sellers for both companies. And, you know, people are often deciding between these two knives, so anyways, I digress. So yes, we have G10 handle scales, which are very nice. They are contoured slightly differently than your standard 940. This area up here by the bolster has been kind of radiused or chamfered to kind of ease that edge a little bit there. It's not quite as a sharp transition into the blade, which I think is nice. And you know, I actually had this knife in hand with a standard 940 side by side. And they really feel pretty darn similar in the hand. The ergonomics or, you know, changes of the knife, to me, in my hands, are almost unnoticeable. Just besides the feeling of the difference with the handle material, with the G10 feeling a bit warmer to the touch. Obviously here we have a flow-through design with these really cool kind of fluorescent green standoffs here, which I think is a cool change to the knife. I really like that. I think the green and the black looks really nice. Real sharp looking there. You know, standard Benchmade USA clip. Glad to see this has a Parkerized clip on it as opposed to the painted Benchmade clip. These wear a lot better than the other clips do. Honestly, the weight on this knife is a little bit less. I don't have the exact numbers with me. You guys can look that up. You know, when it comes to stats and weights and stuff like that, you guys can just find a, you know, search Benchmade 940-2. You know, I'm not going to waste too much time talking about that. But it is lighter. You know, how much lighter? I don't know. Maybe ounce and a half lighter, I would imagine, than the standard 940. It is a noticeable difference, but it's not, you know, earth-shattering. The balance point of this knife is pretty good. If you can see there, it's still pretty much in the forward choil there. Which is about where it's at on the standard classic 940. The 940 is more handle heavy, so it kind of puts more of the weight into your handle. But overall, I would say both of these knives are fairly neutral in their ergonomics and how they handle in hand. So that's good. I mean, it's very comfortable. And something I've kind of learned with these knives is really when you're, you know, doing some hard cutting, it's really good to put your thumb just kind of up here on this ramp. And, you know, that way the knife feels good. If you put your fingers back here, your hand back here, kind of on this aesthetic jimping, I mean, this doesn't do anything for traction. That's just for looks. I always thought the knife felt kind of weird. It kind of had almost, the blade was almost too long based on the handle length. I know that may sound crazy, and a lot of people love kind of the one-to-one ratio, but if you come up here with your thumb, for me, this is where the knife is comfortable. This is where I really like it. So, you know, it's a good knife. You know, I'd wager to say this is one of the best offerings from Benchmade, and that's no surprise. You know, pretty much, if Benchmade did not have the 940 and the Griptilian series, I honestly don't know if they'd be still in business. You know, a lot of their other knives that are coming out are, so-so, not real exciting. I just saw the new 2017 models for Benchmade. Not excited about it. Boring, you know. So, they need to change something. They are completely out of touch with their customer base and what their customers want. I don't even know if they listen to what their customers want. So, this is a good knife. This is a great knife. You know, I actually thought of, you know, picking one of these up myself, particularly since it has the G10 handles. And that was my biggest downfall of the classic 940, was that once you drop or scrape those handle scales, it's going to show forever. And honestly, they just look kind of beat up and ugly once they start to wear. So these handles are going to wear much, much nicer. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this 940-2 is about the same price as a standard 940. So if any of you guys are out there in the market for a 940, I would probably definitely recommend the 940-2 over the standard 940. You know, unless you're kind of a, you know, classic kind of guy and just like the traditional aspects of the green 940, because it's been around forever. You know, I think honestly this knife here has more to offer long term in terms of just how it's going to hold up and things like that, because, you know, the blades are the same, identical blades. Show this mirror polish I put on this guy for my customer. It's like a nice edge. As you can see, this is a first production here, 853 of 1,000. And, you know, standard stuff, S30V, Osborne design. Unfortunately, he's no longer with us, but quickly I will say that the evenness and grind of this blade from the factory was terrible. I set my angle on this knife to sharpen. On this side of the knife, it was hitting the edge of the blade. I flipped it over on this side. That angle was hitting the very shoulder of the blade. It took a fair amount of reprofiling, guys, to get this knife to look the way it does. Probably spent a good 2.5 hours on this knife to get this as even as you guys can see here. Let me see if I can get a little better shot here of this blade, not stab myself at the same time. But yeah, looks nice now, but man, this thing was rough when I got it for a new knife. And one last thing I'll point out here, and this video is not meant to be a rip-on Benchmade knife, but the last few Benchmades I have gotten, the washers inside the pivot, one was facing the right way towards the blade and one was not, and I had another knife just like that. So you know, washers have a smoother dome side and kind of a rougher flat side, and the smoother dome side should always go towards the blade, in my opinion. And I've been finding a lot of knives that they're just not that way. You know, one's one way, one's the other. The action kind of hangs up. So, I don't know. I don't know what they're doing over at Benchmade. If they just have new people working there and they're not telling them how to, you know, put these washers in, or if they're not paying attention, or I don't know what they're doing. But, anyways, just kind of sloppy. So, there you have it. Benchmade 940-2. In my opinion, this is probably the best value of the 940 lineup right now. with a close second being the 940-1501 Knife Works exclusive with the G10 blue accent handle and CPM 20 CV, which is a much better steel, in my opinion, than S30V. But for most of you guys, I don't think you'll know the difference. So either one I think you'll be happy with, just kind of based on what you want to do. So hope everybody out there is doing well, and I will see you guys soon. Thanks for watching.